a significant number of Zimbabwean women have been trafficked to Kuwait over the past months. In line with the Trafficking in Persons Act, the government of Zimbabwe has been seized with the case with a view to facilitate the repatriation of the victims of trafficking. To date, a significant number of victims have been assisted to return back to Zimbabwe. We have reports that more still need to be assisted to return, and the government is working on different modalities to facilitate the safe return of our citizens. As of now, we have 19 other women in the embassy in Kuwait waiting to be repatriated home. So far, we have had 70 women that have returned to Zimbabwe. Legislative and institutional compliance with the Trafficking in Persons Act. The much publicized trafficking case has obviously generated an overwhelming interest on trafficking in persons in general and on Kuwait victims in particular. To this end, there have been quite some responses from the multiplicity of stakeholders from both the state and the non-state actors. Whilst the foregoing is commendable, I wish to emphasize the importance of stakeholder coordination in accordance with the national legislative and institutional frameworks that are in place. As you may be aware, government, through my ministry, enacted the Trafficking Persons Act, within whose framework the current response is and should be coordinated. As the minister responsible for the administration of trafficking in persons, I wish to reiterate the need for efficient coordination in our response to trafficking in persons issues. As clearly provided for in the TIP Act, the TIP Interministerial Committee is chaired by the Ministry of Home Affairs. Accordingly, I wish to stress the importance of coordinating the various stakeholder interventions and the responses through the Ministry of Home Affairs. The first question relates to the politicians who want to take advantage of this unfortunate situation. The political parties involved know themselves, and I'm simply telling them or warning them not to do it again. Secondly, while at it, I also wish to warn political parties that you cannot simply go out there and threaten demonstrations for whatever reason. There are procedures when you want to demonstrate, those you want them properly followed. So political parties, bent on wanting to create chaos and mayhem by calling for demonstrations in our cities, will be dealt with very, very swiftly. So I want to urge colleague political parties, colleague politicians, not to create havoc in a beautiful country like Zimbabwe, where we enjoy untold peace and good quiet. So that is said and done. And I think now those political parties, you know them. Secondly, the victims who came, they've given us very valuable information, and the culprits are all being rounded up so that they can be accordingly dealt with. But it is critically very important that we give information to the general public so that they are not hoodwinked, being promised jobs out of the country. If someone promises you a job out of the country, come and check with this committee that they have read out so that they can assist you accordingly. So we really are urging members of the press to make sure that they publicize as much as possible to all Zimbabweans who may be unfortunate to be approached, so that they do not be hoodwinked, so that they are able to check the information before they take up these offers.